across large parts of England, disrupting travel and closing schools as forecasters are now warning us we're in for what may be the worst snowstorm in centuries. All municipal and township roadways are closed to non-emergency personnel until further notice. Expect severe temperature drops and wind gusts up to 60 miles per hour. Please take shelter immediately and bundle up. We're in for a bloody cold one.
Susan? Is that you? Susan? I'm scattering these tapes to increase our chances of being found. The legend is real. This is not a stunt. I'm a graduate student. student. My name is Allison Sterling, and I come from Strayer University. Susan, is that you? Susan? Is that you?
Thank you. The Celtic legend of Dire Grove has been passed down for centuries from generation to generation. Considered by most a fairy tale, it was told by campfires or as a bedtime story. Again and again it was told until, like most ancient accounts, it bore less resemblance to any factual occurrence and slowly became a superstition. And that is how it remains for over 2,000 years until today. However absurd it may sound, it is my contention that an artifact unearthed 2 days ago in the United Kingdom is evidence that the legend of Dire Grove is in fact very real. Judging by today's turnout, I will assume I am the only one who understands this to be true.
What's with all the top of her ass?
Hey, no messing around. This isn't a pleasure cruise.
Thank you.
to first?
The Royal was found by a bed and breakfast, but it's closed for the season, so we're gonna go camp. Can somebody find it on the map?
Sure. So how long are we gonna be roughing it?
1 or 2 days. The forecast said it's in the 50s, so it shouldn't be that bad.
Hey Al, tell your fans a little bit about what you're doing.
We are gonna go look at some ruins, and then I'm gonna talk to the museum director about the relic that was found at Dire Grove.
Here he is. Dire Grove. Nothing too ominous about that, eh, Governor?
Thank you. Fisherman.
always think I'm gonna forget something.
Okay, so you really think there's truth to this legend?
Well, it is the source of my dissertation. This relic that they found is the missing link. You're gonna believe me when we get to Diagrove.
Got a big enough suitcase? Make sure you lock it. You don't want anybody making off with your auntie. Don't forget the combination.
Oh, I said it to the last four digits of my phone number, so it's easy to remember. Oh, man. Do you think the boys are gonna behave?
It's only for a couple of days. How much trouble can they get into?
Besides, they can carry our stuff.
Speaking of stuff, flashlights.
Oh.
Check. Sleeping bags. Check.
Oh, it's Matt. Should we just tell the guys we'll pick him up a couple hours before the flight?
Sounds good.
Dire Grove, here we go.
Should we just break in?
I don't know about that.
Is it even locked? What are you doing?
Just leaving a note in the guest book.
The legend is real.
When are you going to fill us in on this legend anyway?
Thank you. hunter. I am the 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 hunter. I am the
came all this way. When are you going to tell us about this mysterious legend?
Well, it just so happens that I have my slides from my lecture right here. Roughly 2,000 years ago, on this very spot, lived an ancient civilization called the Celts. What is now Dyer Grove was once the settlement of Galen.
Should we be taking notes?
Four Celts. A hunter, a blacksmith, a farmer, and a fisherman, all gathered in Galen and successfully contacted their deceased ancestors by performing the ceremony with these four magical objects. Unfortunately, a gate was opened between the warm green land of the living and the icy void of the dead.
Hold me.
Not knowing how to close the gates, the Celts watched in horror as the icy land of the dead crept into their world. They realized if they didn't stop the ice, it would overtake the whole earth. So they had to close the gate. They abducted this young woman and thrust her like a sacrifice into the portal. It worked. The ice receded, the earth was green and warm. The Celts collected those magic objects and hid them in different places so that they would never be united again.
And what happened to the girl?
Some people call her the Banshee. Other people call her the Ice Lady. Supposedly, she waits for the discovery of the relics so that she can come back and turn the earth to ice. So that we all may feel her pain.
A few days ago, archaeologists unearthed a relic near Dyer Grove that Alice...
You believe is one of the four devices used to open a gate to another world.
Right.
Thank you.
can't sleep. I'm so cold. Are you freezing?
It's gotta be 20 below in here.
Yeah.
Looks like the fire's out. Where's Matt?
Sleeping bag is cold. Maybe he went to the bathroom.
Matt? Matt? Matt! Hey, Matt! Matt, come on, this isn't funny.
I will help her.
Thank you. I am the blacksmith. I am the blacksmith. I am the blacksmith.
Hey, Matt, come on, it isn't funny.
Come on, dude, we're freezing.
Maybe we should look outside.
Hey, check it out. Footprints.
Dude, where are you?
Matt, it's too cold to be playing out here.
Look. More footprints.
Looks like somebody's been digging holes.
And more holes over here.
Thank you.
need to go get help. We can't just leave him here.
I'll go with her. Will you be okay?
Yeah, just hurry.
Okay, I'll get help. Stay here, okay? Just watch him.
Jack, I'm really scared. I think he's gonna cold up.
Hey, it's gonna be okay. I promise. Okay? We're gonna get out of this. Car, it's too cold or something. It won't start.
Come on.
Did you hear that?
Hear what? You're totally freaking me out. Stop.
She's calling my name.
Jack. Oh, you need to get the car started.
Thank you.
hello?
Susan? Where did you go?
Help! Help!
Come back to the room.
This is a distress call to anybody who finds this tape.
The legend is real. I came here with my friends Susan, Jack, and Matt, and she took all of them. I knew this was gonna happen. It's getting really cold. I can feel the ice moving under. Oh, Susan, are you there? It's Susan!
farmer. I am the farmer. I am the farmer. I am the farmer.
Where's Matt?
He wouldn't stop digging, and I got too cold. It's getting worse out there.
Where's
Jack's gone.
What? To get help?
No, he freaked out and he ran into the woods.
Okay, we need to start a fire right now before we freeze to death.
No, we need to go get help.
No, it's too cold. We need to start a fire right now.
What's that?
I found him behind the desk when I was looking for matches. If we're gonna stay here, that's fine, but keep this with you.
Stop. I am worried about the guys, too. We have to start a fire. I don't know what else to do. There's something out there.
So if they found the first relic, do you think the other three are buried around here somewhere?
That's my guess. The carvings that were on the relic that was found represent the blacksmith, the fire. The Celts place great reverence in the four natural elements of earth, air, fire, water. It just makes sense that the other relics would represent the other elements. Remember who opened the portal? Farmer, earth, fisherman. Water.
So, if the relics came together again, you're saying the portal would reopen and release the soul of the woman trapped thousands of years ago?
Yes, but unfortunately it would also freeze the entire world in the process.
And there'd be no turning back?
I suppose. I mean, that's how the story's been told for thousands of years. Although, the Celts do believe in this mysterious fifth element, which would trump the other four.
What was it?
Roughly translated, it's known as the Silver Soul. There's not a whole lot known about it. It's thought to be highly magical by the Celtic elders, the Druids.
Anyway, if an object representing this fifth element was in some way combined with the other four, it would lock the portal forever.
Let's hope we don't have to find out.
I am.
With the artifacts of Dire Grove now safely locked away, we may begin to reassess our understanding, not only of the ancient Celtic people, but of all civilizations. Might it now be wise to look upon the tales of earlier ages with a renewed curiosity?
Dr. Sterling, much has been discussed of your experience, yet you only briefly described the individual responsible for saving you and your friends. Can you reveal the identity of this Good Samaritan?
That person is asked to remain nameless, but I can give you their business card.